continuing a retrospective of the day. I was on a super high, very close to the vision of oneness. Then I interacted with people, plunged to a low. So what I'm doing is I'm just looking at what happened without trying to get too upset and just say, wow, again, what happened again? How is it that interacting with people can take you, plunge you into upset and confusion? Well, very simply, I've said before, we are addicted to the notion of blending truth and lies, and we think that's this is where our salvation rests. This is the crux of our problem. The ego tells us that we're capable of doing this, and by doing this, that will prove we're greater than God. So we may be on a real high, spiritual high, and we interact with others. We automatically try to harmonize with what they're saying. They may be on a, you know, total personality cult trip. I know that my previous experience in life, I was very, very advanced in music harmony. And in this lifetime, that's carried over, and I will love to harmonize in different ways with whatever is being sung. Almost automatically, I'll try to listen to someone and I'll try to blend with what they're saying to make it more beautiful. So if you listen to lies and you try to blend with those lies to make the lies more beautiful, you're going to get very confused, actually, which is what's happened to me over and over and over again. So there is this underlying dynamic we have in our coma is to see if we can blend truth and lies, thinking that's the solution. So obviously, when you get with somebody who believes in lies, then you're going to try and make them look good by making a blend. Say, you know, let's blend those two, and that's the answer. You know, it is not the answer. It's the greatest deception of all. It's the worst deception of all, that somehow you can blend mutual exclusives. I've gone over this many, many times in many videos, and it bites me again. It bites me again. But in order to not be afraid to go back to a spiritual high again, I have to look at this and feel confident I won't make such a bad mistake again. But I don't know how to relate to people staying in this high spiritual state. I automatically drop down to their level, sort of in a harmonizing way, try to harmonize. But clearly that's not the answer. It leads to tremendous upset and frustration and confusion. And you feel, what happened to my peace of mind that I had? What happened to the clarity I had? It's gone. like it's been stolen from you or something. But it's this effort to harmonize. And nowhere is it ever said that reality is a harmonizing situation. You might say the completely harmony-free everywhereness. See, in order for there to be harmony, there needs to be two aspects, duality, harmonizing. One, what does everywhereness have to harmonize with? What does pure transparency have to harmonize with? What do all these absolutes have to harmonize with? Nothing. There's no harmony. See, we have this delusion that reality is some great harmony. No, it's not. Not at all. It is the great oneness, not the great harmony. It's the ego that is trying to bring about the great harmony, because that preserves itself. It preserves itself, right? Of course, the ego is going to promote this, the great harmony. So you might say the harmony-free, wide-open, harmony-free, uncomposed, faceless, nameless, traceless, all good. There's absolutely nothing that is harmonizing, because there aren't two. There's only one. It's not that this is in harmony with that, with disharmony with that. No, there's no harmony at all. There's only the oneness. So people of this world are always fighting for harmony. That's the personality, that's the ego, that's delusion. We should aim our vowing for the vision of oneness instead of harmony. Very different. But the prevailing spiritual teachings of the world that have become seemingly all pervasive on this planet really are all about harmony, personality harmony, harmony, bringing things into harmony. But what happens is you will avoid the high spiritual clarity then, because the down from coming down off of that is so frustrating and shocking. You know, it's like a continuity problem coming down out of that to try and harmonize with deception and lies. It's truth is not some harmony between life and death. Truth is just eternal life. There's nothing it needs to harmonize with. So when people are into harmony, they will not go into the high, you know, the high clarity of getting clear about the vision of oneness. They won't go to it. They'll aim way, way lower as far as trying to be not too far, you know, not too far above absolute confusion, so they can harmonize with confusion instead of not even be aware of it. So if you're not even aware of confusion, how can you harmonize with it? If you're not even aware of lies, how can you harmonize with it? So really what we have to give up is harmony. Harmony. We have to give up harmony. Which is really giving up harm, right? Giving up harm. We're harming ourselves through the belief in harmony. And yet almost everyone believes in harmony is the answer. It's not. It's the opposite of the answer. And the reason why there's so few in this world that have reached the vision of oneness is because people are afraid. It actually makes a continuity fear when you have to come out of that to try and harmonize with a false viewpoint. For the sake of harmony, you know, let's blend truth and lies here so we can all get along. So it seems to be that, but that must be the answer, we think, from the personality level. Very few are willing to go into depth, looking in depth, because coming out of that, it's shocking. It was really a very lousy experience for me. I still feel lousy, really, very lousy. Shocked. It was a shock of like, wow. Because really, the mind of the ego, of the personality, the conglomerate of defenses is so utterly deluded that there's no similarity whatsoever to you know, the high clarity that you're getting. There's none whatsoever. So it's a shock to the system to even entertain that at all. And so people just learn to avoid that shock by not really going too far on their clarity, which is why we all live a superficial life, really. Don't get anywhere. Wow. So we need some advice on this issue. How do you relate to others who are in extreme coma mode, extreme personality mode? How do you relate to them without this terrible drop out of clarity? Especially when they have leverage over you to demand that you do so. They say, hey, I'm taking this position, giving you an opportunity to harmonize, to be saved. You know, I'm taking this position of madness just so you can harmonize and be saved. Imagine saying to God, God, I'm only taking this position of insanity so you have an opportunity to harmonize with the insanity and be saved. That's what we're really saying. That somehow God needs to be saved by harmonizing with lies. This is a rationalization that people use who are following the ego, they're saying, "Oh, I'm just helping God out, because God has to have something to harmonize with, and so I'm only taking this position to provide this you know harmonizing experience, this, you know, the kind of duality, so to speak. I'm only promoting it for the sake of harmony, promoting opposites for the sake of harmonizing them or something." Yeah, this is all, again, the ego's belief that this is a helpful thing to forget. So I don't know what will happen when if I don't drop out of that. But I have to find out. So we can say, I don't have a harmony problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a harmony problem, I have a continuity problem. The harmony problem has zero value to me. The harmony problem has no value to me. We can try. This one seems so difficult. It's like, wow, is it possible to banish this problem, you know? So ingrained, but we can try. You know, the only problem that I have is the continuity problem. The harmony problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value. Only the vision of oneness has value. I don't have a harmony problem. I have a continuity problem. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. The harmony problem has zero value. Only the vision of oneness has value. Only the vision of oneness has value. So I don't have any harmony problem. I don't have a blending problem. I have a continuity problem. The blending problem has no value at all. Zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value. This is helping. I do not have a harmony problem. I've never had a harmony problem. There is no harmony problem. There's only the continuity problem. The continuity problem is the only problem that I have. The harmony problem is totally without any value. No value whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value. The vision of oneness is the only value that there is. That's what I really want. I don't have any problem. I don't even have any blending problem. I have a continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. The blending problem has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. I don't have a duality problem. I have a continuity problem. Continuity problem is the only problem I have. A duality problem, no value to it. Only the vision of oneness has value. I don't have an oppositional problem. My only problem is the continuity problem. The oppositional problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value. I don't have a compatibility problem. I don't have any compatibility problem. I have a continuity problem, and the continuity problem is the only problem that I have. I have no other problem other than the continuity problem. The compatibility problem is totally without any value. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value. The vision of oneness is the only value that there is. I don't have a harmonizing problem. I have a continuity problem. I have a very severe continuity problem, but I don't have any harmonizing problem whatsoever. I have a continuity problem. Continuity problem is the only problem I have. The vision of oneness is the only resolution there is. Therefore, it's the only value that there is, the vision of oneness. So we're trying here. Some results. I don't have a blending issue. I don't have an integration issue. I don't have any integration issue or problem. I don't have an integration problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an integration problem. I have a continuity problem. Continuity problem is the only problem I have. Vision of oneness is the only value there is. The integration problem has no value. No value. Only the vision of oneness has value. See, it was just habit that got me to jump back into bad patterns. Just habit. It's just so, we're so completely socialized in the wrong way in this world that it's just automatically we just, hey, give and take. Hey, I don't have a give and take problem. I have a continuity problem. The give and take problem has absolutely no value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. The vision of oneness is what I really want. I don't want anything else. I don't want anything else. I don't want any give and take problem. I don't have a give and take problem. I've never had a give and take problem. Hey, I don't have a compromise problem. I've never had a compromise problem. I only have a continuity problem. A compromise problem has no value. None. No value. Only the vision of oneness has value. So this is what I suggest when you get into a funk, you use the continuity technique just like this. And begin to turn the tide against our horrible habits that we have. I don't have a horrible habit problem. I have a continuity problem. Continuity problem is the only problem I have. The vision of oneness is the only resolution of the continuity problem. Therefore, the vision of oneness, only the vision of oneness has value to me. The get along problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. The give and take problem has no value to me. The get along problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. So I don't have a give and take problem. I don't have a get along problem. I only have a continuity problem. The give and take problem has zero value to me. Only a vision of oneness has value. I don't have a compatibility problem. I have a continuity problem. I only have one problem. And it's the continuity problem. I don't have a compatibility problem. I have a continuity problem. The compatibility problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. So hopefully this will lead to something. It's horribly shocking to lose your. I was in this inner wow state, and then to have that just fragment in the most horrible way. Really, it was the most chaotic, super chaotic thing, animalistic, chaotic. Of course, designed to do exactly that. It's amazing how the universe steps up to stop you. You know, like wow. Let's bring them out of that state. diabolical, really. And it's only the Holy Spirit and our own spiritual determination provides a little space for us to see clearly. But the universe rushes in and tries to throw a monkey wrench into it as fast as possible, supporting its own existence, really. The ego, at least how we perceive the universe, immediately that perception defends itself. That misperception defends itself ferociously, diabolically. I don't have a diabolic problem, I have a continuity problem. The diabolic problem has zero importance, zero value to me. Only the vision one that has value. So what if you like take a perfectly calm, still ocean and then take a raging, hurricane-tossed ocean and then say, you know, the answer, what's going to make me happy is to blend the two. What do you get? You don't get stillness, do you? What if what you really want is that still ocean? Then how does blending it make it better? The ego says it's improving upon reality. Of course, we think we're prime creator. We want to be prime creator, and God says, what are you doing? He said, no, we're just improving upon reality. We're blending it with its opposite. Reality has no opposite. I don't have an opposition problem. I have a continuity problem. The opposition problem has no value whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value. I don't have a coming to terms problem. I only have a continuity problem. The coming to terms problem is totally without any value whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value. God doesn't have to come to terms with something. Come to terms with something. What is that? To localize God, to define localization, coming to terms? We think that God needs to come to terms with something. And we're helping God come to terms with something. This is just utter make-believe. Utter make-believe. But we can believe make-believe. It doesn't make it real. There's only one life. There's only one universal eternal life. There's not two lives. So how could there be harmony, harmonizing? One life harmonizing with another is impossible. There is no life harmony problem. There's only a continuity problem. I only have a continuity problem. The life harmonizing problem is totally without value and completely non-existent. Only the vision of oneness has value. Life doesn't need to harmonize with itself or with some other life. Nothing is in some process of harmonizing with anything. Truth is exactly as it is. It's true. It doesn't need to become true. It doesn't need to become more true. See, I always thought that help is to take something ugly and make it more beautiful. That's not the answer. That is not the answer. Take a sad song, take a song that's okay, dress it up, and make it even better. And I say, see, that's progress. That's what we need to do. No. I don't have a progress problem. I have a continuity problem. Progress problem is completely devoid of all meaning and all value. Only a vision of oneness has value and meaning. So I'll have to see if I can get out of this minor funk that I've gotten in without getting depressed. To lose like the highest spiritual high I've been able to get so far, this deep, deep, deep rearranging of my expectations, and then to be, you know, hit with just this terrible scenario right off the bat. And even when I was planning to make sure it didn't happen, like the worst thing imaginable happened, you know, just something that was custom designed to interfere with it. think it was showing me that this spiritual effort that we're making in the world is going to be under severe attack very soon. That there's going to be very much animalistic activity in the world. People are going to sink down into the level of animal. Personality actually sees safety in animal behavior, behaving like animals. Sees safety in that. They see safety in panic, in viciousness, and in feeling they're being attacked. When someone's trying to help them, they actually feel they're being attacked. And so that's what happened. That's what happened, actually. I was trying to help this cat go outdoors that needed to go get used to being outdoors, and it got all panicky, and I was running around. I tried to pick it up because it wouldn't go outside, even though it wanted to, but and picking it up, it started scratching me and bit me. You know, and it was just like a totally chaotic situation, just like, you know, just wow, this freaked out cat biting me. But the whole purpose of everything was to help this cat get where it wanted to go, which was outdoors. So I thought, I'm just trying to help this cat that's a little confused. But it took it, thought that I was attacking it, you see. So I believe it was pointing out to me that the world, when you try to help the world coming up, the world's going to think that you're attacking it. And it's going to bite you. Which is why I again believe there is a need to sidestep this whole situation and not try being hero to the world at this point in time. I don't care what anybody says. All my experiences and understanding point to this, is this is what's going to happen. There is going to be a time when temporarily the world is so panicked, any attempt to help them will be seen as an attack. And it's better to just let them calm down. Even though they're not getting to a better situation, you know they want to get there. They're too confused. They're too confused right now. The effort on the part of the extraterrestrials here on this planet, not all ETs are so bad, but the ones here, some of the ones on this planet who've been interfering with this planet are really terrible in terms of their fear-based, personality-based delusions. They have developed this personality cult in the world, which can get extraordinarily confused, like a wild animal getting trapped. They feel like a wild animal trapped, and the wild animal's gonna bite whoever comes close to it. You get in that situation, you just have to back off. Let everybody calm down. And somehow this wildness, this feral wildness of the personality cult needs to start dissipating. But I've been told is there will be a time when you just have to step away and not play the hero. And that's what I've been aiming for. Panic can set in easily into the personality cult because there's no self there, actually. There's no will there. And it'll suddenly just start acting in what it thinks is a willful manner, but which is a self-destructive manner, right? Any attempt to help, they think is actually trying to destroy them, because they think that what they're doing is helping themselves. So obviously, if they're acting in a self-destructive way, and they define that as helpful to them, acting in a helpful, constructive, non-self-destructive way automatically is defined as trying to destroy them, destructive way. That's just the problem of insanity. Is you get it backwards, and then you think in order to, so you don't get freaked out about what you're doing, you insist that the ones are helping, trying to help you, are the ones trying to hurt you, in order to think that you're not trying to hurt yourself. It's really a vicious, you know, a vicious circle type of thing. So sometimes when you just try to be helpful, which is what I was trying to do, I was really protesting. I finally said, okay, let's just get over with it. It backfires on you. It really backfires. So you got to trust in the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit says, look, this situation will backfire on you if you try to help. You got to let the situation cool out. It's an extraordinary period where there's just been massive interference with this planet, massive manipulation of this planet, and people are truly in a very turned around, confused condition at this point. But full of aggrandized personality traits, thinking for sure that they know what's best for everybody. Even though it's 180 degrees backwards. So I wish the Holy Spirit would do something about this right away. Really, I pray for that. That if there's a way to sidestep it, we need to sidestep it now. You know, just stop fooling around with the situation and get used to realizing that harmony is not the way. Harmonizing is not the way. Helping is not the way, really. I don't have a help problem. I have a continuity problem. The help problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value. Let the Holy Spirit give the help, okay? It's not our role to help, really. It's our role to accept our own salvation. It's the Holy Spirit's role to help. So we should just take directions from the Holy Spirit as to what it wants us to do. If it wants us to sidestep, then we know that's the best thing for it, for all involved. So hopefully this complex of information will come through on this. I'm getting so much feedback that the world is not ready for its wow moment. It's ready for its panic moment. Panicking down into confusion, thinking that's salvation. Trying to force this harmony upon the world, homogenization upon the world. And the world's in a very feral condition right now. People are very feral and animalistic now. Good grief. Just look at the people you go out and just look and say, oh my gosh, they are so animalistic. Compared to the spiritualized people that there have been some around, and there were times when people were trying to, it's so completely different. So completely different. So the cult of personality is in charge right now. And you get into that, you'll get into this harmonizing thing, and then they'll think that you're attacking them, and it's just, I don't know, it's a nightmare. So I need more clarity on this. We all need more clarity on this. We need clarity on sidestepping this whole situation. I want it now. I want it now. I want it now. Ready for it. Okay, let's see if it comes. That's it for this one.